So in this video we're going to discuss the phase portrait for a swinging pendulum. Okay, so we've got a pendulum like this, and it swings backwards and forwards. And we want to understand the equations that govern this. Okay, so there's two parameters we are interested in. There's the angle theta, so that's theta is the angle away from the horizontal, from the vertical. So when we're over to the right, theta is going to be positive, and when we're swinging over to the left, theta is going to be negative. It's this angle from the vertical line to the bar of the pendulum. And then there's omega, is the angular velocity, the rate of change of theta. So two equations that govern these things. Well, firstly, because omega is just defined to be the rate of change of theta, we've just got theta dot is omega. Yeah, everything's depending on t, and the dots mean the derivative with respect to t, so theta dot is equal to omega. Whereas omega dot, that's kind of the angular acceleration, and that's going to be minus sine theta. Okay, so that's going to be the horizontal component of the gravitational pull on the pendulum bob. You've got a kind of constant mass of the pendulum bob, so constant force, constant gravitational force pulling downwards. But the force pulling downwards is not what's relevant. It's the force that's kind of pulling inwards back towards the center. And to get that, you know, you have to multiply by sine theta, because the pull is going to be, in this picture, it's going to be mostly downwards, and only a kind of small component of it is pulling inwards. So that's what we've got. So here's this is the phase plane. So you've got theta is the horizontal coordinate and omega is the vertical coordinate. Okay. So we look here. Okay, so this point, this is the origin right in the middle there. And so we're a bit to the right of the origin. So theta is positive because we're swinging to the right. And also we're still swinging further to the right. So moving to the right, theta is increasing, which means that omega is positive. So we're above the horizontal line. The horizontal line here is omega is zero. Vertical line here is theta is zero. And this at this point here, omega and theta are both positive. When we get to here, okay, so now theta's gone back to zero. Right? We're on the vertical horizontal line, it's theta zero. But we are still moving to the left. Okay, and I froze it, but we were still swinging to the left. So omega is negative because we're swinging leftwards. Theta is decreasing, and if we start again, yeah, we carry on swinging that way. we on the phase plane, we're going round in a little circle like this. So it kind of looks like a circle. It's not quite a circle. If we had omega dot is minus theta, then it would actually be a circle. And we're doing here radian measure, when theta is small, sine theta is approximately equal to theta, so we're looking up, you know, approximately omega dot is minus theta, which means that theta double dot is minus theta. That's your equation for simple harmonic motion. Let's see what happens approximately when theta is small. We let theta get larger. Now we've got these kind of big wild swings like this. And so now you're seeing the non-linearity of the sine, so this instead of going around a circle on the phase plane, this is a kind of a bulgy thing, not really an ellipse either. It's some other kind of shape. But we still got these kind of closed contours. And then if we go on this line here, okay, so we went a little bit too high. Let's go a little bit lower. Okay, so this is. We're almost going over the top, but we're still within this kind of lens-shaped region of the phase portrait, where the trajectories are all closed curves, and so we're just going backwards and forwards. But if we go just slightly outside this lens-shaped thing, so now we're going all the way over the top. And so theta's above the horizontal line here. So omega is positive, means theta's increasing. We're swinging out to the right, and theta's continuously increasing. You see, I've wrapped this around so that when we come off the right end here, then we pop back onto the left. that's kind of a reflection of the fact that theta's an angle, so multiples of 2 pi don't really make a difference to theta. So it's natural to just kind of wrap it all around to the left again. So that's what happens if we go kind of above here. And if we go higher up, then now omega dot is larger, and now we're kind of swinging quite wildly, and you see here that omega is approximately constant. Okay, we've got enough energy that we're just swinging around. The gravity is not really making much difference, and we've just got constant, more or less constant angular velocity. We slow down a little bit as we go up to the top, and speed up a little bit as we go down to the bottom. Basically, we're just swinging at more or less constant velocity. And bottom of the phase portrait is kind of the same, except that here we're swinging in the opposite direction. So here we're below the horizontal line, which is where omega is zero. So omega is negative down here. That means theta is decreasing. We're moving to the left. And the numbers are actually shown here, right? You see that, you can see here that omega is decreasing. We've always done this in multiples of pi, so that omega is zero there. Yeah, let's do it a bit more slowly. So here, yeah, we've got omega is about minus 1 pi. Now omega is minus 2 pi. Theta is minus 2 pi. Theta is about minus 3 pi, and then up to, yeah, and then goes back to the other side. So, or if we do it in here, okay, so this is where theta is about 0. Theta is about minus pi over 2 as we're kind of swinging to the vertically to the left. Now here we've got theta is 0 again, because we're hanging straight down. And here theta plus half pi, and we're more or less out to the right. Okay, so this is our phase portrait for the differential equations governing the behavior of the pendulum.